If you're a serious gamer, a creator, or a professional who demands desktop-class performance but needs the portability of a laptop, well then, you'll want to consider a laptop with the 11th Gen Intel Core H-Series processor, codenamed Tiger Lake H. Now, for a full understanding of everything Intel 11th Gen Core H-Series has to offer, we recommend you watch this entire video start to finish. But if you're already familiar with some of these features, or you're particularly interested in one or more, feel free to skip around by clicking on one of the chapters listed in the description below. We expect each new CPU generation to perform significantly better than the last. What drives the biggest increases in overall CPU performance? There are many important elements and they've changed over time, but one of the most significant and lasting is clock speed. Clock speed, simply put, refers to the frequency at which a CPU can carry out instructions. The more instructions your CPU can complete per second, the more things your CPU can do in a shorter amount of time, and the higher performance you can achieve. This can equate to anything from faster video renders to higher frame rates while gaming. Intel's very first CPU, the first commercially produced microprocessor in fact, called the Intel 4004, had a max clock speed of 750 kHz. By contrast, some versions of the 11th Gen Intel Core H-Series processors can achieve turbo-boosted clock speed up to 5 GHz on not just one, but up to two cores, which is new for this generation, and that's 5 billion cycles per second. This stacks up very well thanks to the new Willow Cove microarchitecture that allows 11th Gen to get more work done every cycle, even at equivalent clock speed. This means that when you buy a laptop with an Intel 11th Gen Core processor in it, you'll be purchasing one of the highest performing laptops ever produced. For some people, even having the fastest processor out of the box isn't enough, and that's where overclocking comes in. You might already know that overclocking means raising the rate at which something clocks, or the frequency at which it's supposed to run. It can apply to any number of computer parts, but here we're talking about it in relation to the CPU. Why would anyone do such a thing? Well, it's the same reason I start each day by slamming a hot cup of coffee in the morning. To get that extra nice performance boost that comes from pushing your hardware past its factory settings. Like caffeine, overclocking your PC is generally pretty safe and potentially addictive. If you're into overclocking your laptop, you'll want to get the 11980HK for full overclocking freedom. But there are several other models that are partially unlocked and can still benefit from overclocking. It's made even easier if you use Intel's Extreme Tuning Utility, or XTU, which lets you stably overclock your PC with just a few clicks. That means you can instantly boost performance whenever and wherever you need it. You can even tweak the voltages to make things run a little cooler. Ultimately, unlocked processors give you extra control over how you want to run your CPU. Let's get into PCIe Gen 4. With PCIe Gen 4, we are doubling the bandwidth your PC can handle. Gen 4 gets that bandwidth up to a whopping 64 gigabytes per second. Oh, and by the way, PCIe Gen 4 has 20 lanes directly attached to the CPU. They don't have to go through a PCH or a platform controller hub. This means data gets to the CPU faster and more efficiently. PCIe Gen 4 means quicker media loading and saving. This is a desktop level feature for the creator on the go. Now, 11th Gen Intel Core processors will power the very best in enthusiast laptops. And no laptop is an island. I'll explain. Being able to level up your laptop with external monitors and peripherals is key. And that's where Thunderbolt 4 comes in. See, it's coming in right there to the side of that laptop. Now take a good look, because that one little Thunderbolt 4 cable can handle up to two 4K monitors, external storage devices, and a bunch of other peripherals like keyboards, mice, and drawing tablets, flowing through one itty bitty little cable that delivers 40 gigabits of bidirectional bandwidth, all while charging your laptop. If you need even more graphical power than the discrete GPU can offer, you can even run an external GPU through Thunderbolt. Oh. And Thunderbolt 4 runs through that awesome USB-C connector that Intel helped develop that's taken the industry by storm, and it doesn't give a flip which way it's plugged in. For gamers, this means you can get most out of your top-of-the-line peripherals, and for creators, it means all that plus a fast and safe connection to external storage devices when backing up large files and projects. And no matter how many monitors, peripherals, or USB-powered coffee mug heaters you've got plugged into your Thunderbolt dock, when it's time to take your machine on the go, you just disconnect that one little cable and you're on your way. How often has this happened to you? You're on a video call and your connection starts to slow down and drops altogether. Annoying, right? Well, Wi-Fi 6E enabled in 11th gen Intel Core platforms, you'll be able to take video calls, stream movies, game competitively online, and anything else you do with your Wi-Fi fast with low latency and limited drops in service. Wi-Fi 6E is the future of Wi-Fi, and you're going to want your next computer to support this exciting new standard. So, what is Wi-Fi 6E, and how can it deliver on such a huge promise? Since its introduction more than two decades ago, Wi-Fi has operated on two bands, 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. When you're experiencing connectivity issues or problems with your Wi-Fi, that's usually caused by congestion within these bands. This wasn't as much of a problem when Wi-Fi was relatively new, but now that the number of devices has grown in orders of magnitude, these congestion issues are just getting worse. Thankfully, there's a solution. With Wi-Fi 6E, we are able to access a third band, that's 6 GHz. That's actually what the E stands for, extended into the 6 GHz band. This means that if you're the first person with a Wi-Fi 6E enabled router and computer in your apartment building, you'll have the entire band to yourself. Great, but what happens when more and more people get Wi-Fi 6E routers and computers and the band becomes more congested? This new 6 GHz band has significantly more spectrum space compared to the previous bands, 1200 MHz instead of 400 MHz. This is the largest increase in spectrum availability for Wi-Fi ever, and only Wi-Fi 6E is able to take advantage of it. One thing to keep in mind, you won't be able to take full advantage of Wi-Fi 6E until you have a compatible router, and that band has been approved by your local regulator. The good news is that Wi-Fi 6E laptops are also fully compatible with existing Wi-Fi hardware, including Wi-Fi 6, which is still great. Once you have a compatible router and a laptop powered by an 11th gen Intel Core H series processor, you'll be on the forefront of a new Wi-Fi frontier with a whole band all to yourself. And the best part is, you won't ever have to deal with this ever again. Let's talk SSD RAID. We'll dig into the two of the most common configurations available on the Intel 11th Gen Core processors. That's RAID 0 and RAID 1. What makes RAID 0 so great is its speed. It stripes or splits your data across all your banded drives. While maximizing read and write speeds, RAID 0 doesn't guarantee reliability. If one RAID 0 banded drive goes down, you lose all your data. After all, each drive only has a fraction of the data. But this was a much larger concern back in the age of spinning magnetic hard drives, which aren't nearly as reliable as a solid state storage today. Now, failures can still happen with SSDs, but they are far more rare. And for that reason, RAID 0 is probably what I'd run in my system. So RAID 0 is great for gamers, especially those who play games with cloud-based saves. And RAID 0 with cloud-based backups gets you quicker load times without the fear of losing your data. What's more, Intel Rapid Storage Technology, or Intel RST, allows you to boot from RAID 0, giving you the full benefits of RAID without any additional hardware. It's just all built in. So, where RAID 0 is fast, RAID 1 is actually great for reliability. RAID 1 immediately duplicates the data written to one SSD to another banded drive for redundancy purposes. It's in the name, redundant array of independent disks. You get the reliability and support of two drives. Now, if one of your SSD gives out with RAID 1, you're not really losing a thing. You still got that backup. RAID 1 is an awesome fit for creators who need the dependability of multiple drives and can't risk losing their crucial files. Fortunately, 11th gen Intel Core processors, H series, let you pick and choose which RAID setup is best for you. So, those are just a few of the outstanding features of the 11th gen Core H series processors. It's an exciting new addition to the Intel processor family, and we're excited to share it with you. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments. I'm Marcus Yam, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.